Today I'm going to show you how to make this. Using nothing but FL Studio drums and plugins. Let's do this shit!
I hope every single comment is a joke about my hairline. Alright, I'm ready for it. Hit me with the hairline jokes.
Here we have... the basic ass 808s kit thing that comes to FL Studio.
Okay, this is cool. This is a cool idea, except that it's literally right in front of my fucking face. I can't see.
First, we need to get the tempo, right? So, what am I feeling right now? I'm feeling like a... Wow, that is not a trap tempo at all. Okay, that's a little better. That's a little better. All right. 135. So let me set some hats. All right, so I want to get some triplets in here. So I'm going to go to this little fucking magnet thing, go to three steps and make some triplets. Right. That's not what I wanted, but it's dope. Let's save this shit. Always control S, okay? Your main fucking shortcut that you should learn right off the bat when you're making music, control S. Control S is gonna save your ass. So don't forget to press that S. Wait, what? So now we need an 808. Let's put it on one of these so that we can fuck with the MIDI. So I'm gonna just edit this in the audio editor and find out what the pitch region is, which is a G. So this thing's is a G. So here, go to this little wrench thing and pick fucking G so that it knows that the root note is a fucking G. Oh, and turn on this crossfade so that it doesn't overlap. Now let's make a little bass line. So since this is a trap hit, and this is gonna be for the clubs, obviously, you know, for people to get lit as fuck, get drunk, get turnt, you know, just get fucking wild and do drugs if they want to. All right, so this trap beat is gonna be for the clubs. We need to keep this bass like real fucking thumpy, you know, like real. So like, we want to keep the bass line between E, F, or G, because these are bass frequencies that respond very well in club environments. All right, so if you have shitty ass headphones or speakers, you probably won't hear this. Let me channel it to one of these motherfuckers, and I'm gonna put a wave shaper. Now what this is gonna do is bring out the upper harmonics and make it more audible. Oh yeah, Ronnie J, where you at? All right, now what I'm gonna do is sidechain the 808 bass under the kick so it's not so fucking disgusting. I'm gonna channel this to its own track, and then I'm gonna rename this one to sidechain. And then I'm gonna automate the fucking volume thing as my sidechain. So I basically wanna follow the shape of the kick, but this kick right here, I'm going to shorten it up. So I'm gonna go to declicking mode, go to generic, and then kind of just drag it like this while I'm holding alt. And it just shortens it up, you know? And I want it to be maybe about this long. So we're gonna have the sidechain go around there and then be completely flat here. So what's happening, the volume of the 808 is being ducked under the kick. All right, that's trap as fuck, dude, honestly. I'm actually surprised. I thought I was gonna have to do a lot more, but you know what? I do wanna show you a lot more. So from here, I can add effects to these sounds, right? So like the main thing that you wanna do and fuck with, I'd say, is called a parametric equalizer. It's like a graphic form of the sound frequencies, right? So here in FL Studio's parametric EQ, it lights up. So you can see here, the sound changes when I add these frequency peaks. Now, if I were to remove some of these, the sound completely changes. If you're barely starting to make music, fuck with the EQs. They are extremely helpful to understanding the whole world of sound. Like I said, you can do this to every sound. So now let's put one on the 808 and turn up the bass frequencies. I want this 808 to be a little bit more sustained. And how could I possibly do that if the sound itself is fading out? As you can see here, the sound is slowly fading out. So we're gonna use a limiter for this. Let's just put the fruity limiter on it and I'll play the note. Now you can see the waveform rolling off, right? So what I'm gonna do is set a ceiling around the highest point of it. And I'm gonna turn up the gain. So now the sound's kind of like this fat sausage thing that's getting flattened. A lot of people don't like this. Some people do. This can be cool, but you can do it with different ways, right? There's also a way to doing it with a little bit of saturation. And finally, an EQ on the hat where I can just cut off complete frequencies. I want my hi-hats to live in the higher spectrum of the fucking thing. So we had a trap beat now. Okay, so now that we got that going, we need a lead, right? So I think we should do like some OG trap stuff with the vocal lead or something with the high pitch something in the fucking top with a lot of reverb, and it just sounds like it's in a big ass arena. I could go into my sample packs, but I kind of wanted to use all of FL Studio stuff. Oh shit, I think FL Studio has stock vocals. They do.
I would like
it's a smash.
Jack it up.
Okay, we need a beat. Okay, let's go.
What time is it?
Oh, what time is it, bitch?
What time is it?
I'm just gonna start chopping this up.
What time?
Okay, so let's channel this to the mixer again. This is where we fucking add some effects. For sure, I'm gonna go into my racks here and fucking grab this Bright Rack, my go-to little plug-in shit that I made. You fucking bitches! Get off my fucking coffee, you stupid-ass ants. All right, so let's see what the fuck this did to the sound. Let's reset the pitch, see what happens.
What?
But we can also take it into, let's go edit an audio editor, find out what the note this is. So it's a C. So perfect, it's already on a root note. I can just drag it back in over here, so now I can use it as an instrument. So let me channel it back to. And what I can do here as well, let's go here and go to the pitch modulation tab, and I can create an envelope to kind of create pitch bending thing on the sound. So now I can take all this shit out and just create a new pattern, and we're gonna call this one like voice lead or some shit. And then we're gonna put that voice lead here and go to piano roll and then just go. I'm gonna mess with the sound right here inside the pitch. All right, cool. So we're getting somewhere with the melody. I'm gonna put this thing on one voice, portamento, and set the slide to where it sounds kind of cool, where the notes are changing and shit. This is gonna make the notes glide. All right, so this sounds very like 2014 trap. So let's give it some 2020 in there just by adding some delay on it and making it like ringy and shit. Let's just do it with the fucking delay too. We're gonna cut the time hella short, like maybe around like up here you can see like fucking 3 or some shit. And let's see what that sounds like. Wow, I just realized we didn't put an EQ on this one, so what the fuck? Just make it like this. I fucking hate this. I think the vocal is what's pretty fucking ass, so let's replace the vocal with like any one of these. And what I'm gonna do is, well, I don't know the root note, but I'm just gonna mess around by like turning this sample start. So it's gonna start, you know, searching through until we find something that kind of sounds good. I didn't sidechain this shit. So we're gonna go here and then sidechain and then fucking. Oh my god, let's get a little bit crazier in here. Add some fucking slide notes, huh? Let me press this little button up here and fucking, you know, make a little slidey note right here and it goes. Okay, I want to add more stuff to this shit. Let's look through some of these FL Studio sounds. Oh, there's a cowbell. Oh my god, we have to add a cowbell in here. Okay, so the final little last note is gonna be a fucking cowbell, bitch. Fuck that slidey note right there. Shit! No, we need to go like two little. Perfect, bro. Okay, now we need. Oh, that sounds nice too. Some pretty cool sounds in here, dude. Okay. I'm actually hella surprised by the sounds in here. I want like a crash, you know, like a. That's the 808 crash. That's so ass. All right, so we're gonna take this crash, put it on a channel, put some reverb on it so it just fucking, you know, it's a longer. I just put an AK-47 to your crib, then I shoot your shit, bitch. You ain't shit. Now, when you're finally done with this thing, you know, you put some fucking drums, you put a fucking vocal lead, you put some extra shit in there. Now you want to put something on the master, you know what I mean? If you're just starting out, this is what I would recommend, just because, like, this is what I wish somebody would have told me. I wanted my shit to be really loud without, like, clipping all the time. So this is just a little trick, okay? Nothing professional at all, just a little trick. Turn up the ceiling, so there's no ceiling at all. What is going to work as our ceiling is the saturation knob. So once it reaches this threshold, you know, this little red line that just appeared right there, it's gonna start saturating the sound. I think something along those lines, but you can turn it up and yes, it will get distorted, but at least it won't necessarily clip. It will be controlled. This shit reminds me of like something icy, like it just be cold. Brrr. Yeah, it's cold. Yeah, I'm cold, just like ice. I'm not nice. Put up fast in my ass. That's gonna be it for today's video. I hope you guys learned something. I'm thinking about doing more beginner videos because I know a lot of more people are getting interested in music and I wanna help and reach out to them. Just because I remember when I started, there was nobody who really taught me in any like cool way. It was just a bunch of like really complicated words that I didn't understand and I just wanted to make music. Other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. If you want this project, as always, it's available for my Patreons. So consider becoming a Patreon and I'll see you guys on the next shit.